Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to use calculation groups to let your users choose between multiple dates that might be present in your model. Let's start immediately looking at the example. I have this report that is showing by year and month the sales amount, the sales quantity, and the distinct number of products that were sold in a given period. Everything is working just fine. But if we take a look at the data model, you see that I have multiple dates in this model. I have the delivery date, the date when the order is delivered, and the order date, the date when the order is placed. And because I have two dates, I have created two relationships between sales and date. The first one is based on the order date and it is active. The second one is based on the delivery date, and that is kept inactive in order to avoid ambiguity in the model. I want to be able to build not only this report, but also a report that uses the relationship based on the delivery date. So the numbers are different in this report because I'm showing the delivery amount, the delivery quantity, and the delivery product. And I already did it by creating several measures. I have the delivery amount that computes sales amount, and by using calculate, it changes the active relationship by using use relationship. In a similar way, I created the delivery products and the delivery quantity. The thing is, if I have two relationships and three measures, I end up building six measures, and the number of measures increases with the increase of number of measures and relationship. That's why I want to do something different. I want to reuse the existing measure, sales amount, quantity, and products, but use a slicer to choose between the order date, and I still have the same values that I have for the sales amount. But when I click on delivery date, the same calculation will work under a different relationship. I want to do everything using calculation groups. So what I did is creating a calculation group that has two values, one that returns the same value as the sales amount, and a second value, a second calculation item that will activate the inactive relationship and then compute sales amount or whatever measure the user put in the report. Now, the solution is already there, but what I want to do is show you step by step how to create this solution. So we are now going back to the Power BI desktop file, remove the current solution and rebuild it together. Let's start. First of all, we need to kill the current solution. So let me go here and delete this calculation group. Of course, my report will stop working, but that is something we will fix it step by step. What I need to do is go to external tools, launch tabular editor, and then I switch to it. In tabular editor, I need to create a new calculation group. So under table, I choose new calculation group, and we need to provide a name, date to use. We also need to provide a name for the column of the calculation group. We use again date to use. And finally, we need to create calculation items. The first one will not do anything, so it just returns selected measure. By returning selected measure, it does not change the behavior of the current measure. Once this is done, I forgot to give it a name. I name it order date because this is the calculation group that uses order date. I save it. If I go back to Power BI Desktop, you see that it says that one or more calculation groups need to be refreshed. Let's do it. I still have the old selection, okay. Now I have only one calculation item, order date, and if I click on it, nothing happens. That's totally expected, because my calculation item right now is not changing the behavior. Let's build the second calculation item that will activate the desired relationship. So I create a new calculation item. This time I call it delivery date. And in the code, I will now use calculate, the selected measure, and then use relationship because I want to activate a different relationship. And I activate the relationship between sales delivery date and date. That's it. Whenever I will call this calculation item, I will use this calculation item, the selected measure will be executed in a new context where the active relationship is the one that I want. I need just to confirm it, go back to File, Save, switch to Power BI Desktop, and I need to refresh it again because I created a new calculation item, and now I have order date and delivery date. Order date is still computing the same value, but if I click on delivery date, now you see that the same measures that I was using earlier are now using a different relationship. As you have seen, you can use calculation items, which are an extremely powerful feature, also to do simple things, like change the active relationship between the multiple ones that you typically have with the data. You might also have different dimensions that have different relationships, but usages like these are very simple and very effective. If you are interested in these topics, go to sqlbi.com. There you will find the article that describes this technique, and you will also be able to download the demo file, start playing with it in order to learn how to implement it in your models. Enjoy, DAX!